How does this compare to things you've seen in the past?
Well, Larry, once again, every one of these disasters has its own personality. But I have to say, seeing the destruction here today, how people's lives have been affected, we're especially concerned about children. And I think the common view, or the view that certainly I share, is that we just need more help. You know, we don't have enough water, we don't have enough medical supplies, we don't have enough blankets, and there's people that just aren't getting the help that they need, and it's just not acceptable.
Why is it so hard getting supplies in?
Well, we first of all, because of the situation in the country to begin with, there isn't a lot of residual supplies here anyway. And then it's just the inability really to get them here fast enough. There's capacity issues at the airport. And of course, there just continues to be challenges with the broken infrastructure that affects our distribution here. But I'd have to say right now, it's more an issue of getting it here so that it's available now, not 2 weeks from now or not 3 weeks from now.
But you've dealt with this 35 years. Does it ever get to be, you know, I don't want to say old hat, but is it just another day, or is it every experience more emotional than the next?
I have to say, if I get to that point, then I really think it's time for me to quit, because every one of these touches you. Today, I was at a local hospital where our volunteers were distributing medical supplies and nursing wounds of people that had been injured. And I was watching them, and then to the side, a man brought up a skeletal 10-year-old child that was hardly alive. Obviously, this had happened even before the earthquake. Then on the street was a man carrying a casket, a family grieving. Then there were two men walking down the street, one leaning on the other, just weeping profusely. And then I looked off to the left, and there was a dying young woman. She had died and was laying along the street. That's both a hospital is to be a place of healing, but it's also a place of despair. And that's the combination that we have here in Haiti right now.